This is not a game. This is a 12-week job interview. Never, ever, ever underestimate me.
14 people came to London in search of a job.
I don't like liars. I don't like cheats. I don't like bullshitters. I don't like schmoozers. I don't like arse-lickers.
They've come to battle it out for a job with Sir Alan Sugar.
I would have told you to piss off.
Tough and uncompromising, Sir Alan is at the top of his game with a global empire worth £700 million. He's offering one job with a six-figure salary.
I'm going to fucking win this night if it kills me.
To get it, they'll have to work and live together.
Oh, lovely!
And face a weekly business task.
You can't fucking fire me!
Do you feel the pressure is building?
This is the ultimate job interview.
You're fired. You're fired. You're fired.
Last week, the candidates met Sir Alan for the first time.
You're going to have to demonstrate to me your skills in leadership, business acumen, shrewdness, the lot.
They were split into two teams, girls and boys, and told to come up with company names.
Impact.
The meaning of impact is its impact.
Boom. Impact.
First quarter.
First quarter.
First quarter.
They were given the first of their weekly tasks.
You're going out in the street tomorrow and you're going to be selling something. Flowers.
You buy a bunch, I'll buy you a bunch.
The boys charmed their way to a healthy profit.
And I'm getting annoyed about it.
The girls failed to agree a strategy and lost.
Can you please listen to me?
Yeah.
The winners got a trip to the London Eye.
Cheers. Cheers.
To impact.
The losers faced the boardroom and Sir Alan. He held girls' project manager Syra accountable.
As project manager, I had a clear strategy. That strategy was not followed.
Syra had to choose the two girls she felt had let the team down.
Adenike and Miranda.
You gave me responsibilities which you weren't confident enough to take on yourself.
I've heard enough, ladies.
The final decision on who to fire was up to Sir Alan.
My decision is Adenike, you're fired.
One candidate down, now 13 remain to fight for the chance to become the apprentice. At the house, the other candidates are waiting to see who will return from the boardroom.
Told you!
Well done!
Oh my God!
You're back.
It would be you too. I just said to him,
How are you feeling?
I've just run a marathon.
We understand that it was a very hard day for you, Zot, and we did get a really good surprise in terms of going around on the London Eye. Obviously, you lost a team member. We did bring you back a bottle of champagne.
After a night of celebrations, there's an early start. 6:30 a.m.
Hello?
Sir Alan wants to see you in Berkeley Square at 8 a.m. The cars will pick you up in 45 minutes and are leaving at 7:15 sharp.
Berkeley Square. Berkeley Square. Shh. Berkeley Square. 8 o'clock sharp. We're leaving in half an hour.
Okay. Get ready as quietly as possible. Yesterday, before we were getting ready for the task, they went downstairs and raided every single cupboard of every single piece of food they could. And if Matthew hadn't heard them doing that, we would have been starving for the whole day. So now, for that little competitive edge, we decided to get ready as quickly as possible. If they're leaving at 7:15 sharp, we've got to go. We answered the phone first. It's a game, isn't it? Really? Really?
I think they're going to have to go and wake up the girls. But at least we're going to get some hot water first.
Tim?
Yeah?
Was that the phone?
Yes, it was. I can't change my room.
What's going on now?
2 seconds, darling. Give me a chance.
What's going on, boys?
We had a feeling that it was going to be an early start. So we all sort of,
We're trying to be compos mentis quite early, just in case the phone rang, which it did. And the girls, as usual, very late risers, slumbering around. It's going to be the undoing of them, isn't it? The girls' team.
Tim? Do we have to be somewhere?
In 2 seconds.
Can you tell us now?
Just give me 2 seconds.
Tim?
Slightly ungentlemanly, not waking the girls up.
No, definitely not. If that was a team of blokes,
it's
we wouldn't
personal.
Have worked,
right? It's business.
Exactly.
At 5 to 7, Tim finally wakes Rachel and Syra.
Got a phone call from France here. We need to be at Berkeley Square at 8 o'clock.
What time?
8 o'clock. So the vans are leaving here at 5:15. Quick as possible, yeah?
We've got 20 minutes. Fucking hell. A little bit odd that they didn't let us know what was going on. They're probably scared of us as a team. So I guess any little advantage they think they can get for themselves, they'll try and take.
Boys,
yeah.
What are we going to wear?
Huh?
What are we wearing?
Business.
It's around, isn't it?
The candidates head for a briefing by Sir Alan. Location, a luxury car showroom in London's Mayfair.
Good morning.
Morning.
Last week, our task was all to do with sales. Now, what I'm looking for in my apprentice is a broad portfolio of skills. Now, when people ask me, what is it about business that I like? To me, innovating and designing the product is top of the list for me. So, what we're looking at here is one of the finest engineered motor cars in the world. You have no idea how much design and engineering goes into a product like this. So today's task is designing and innovating a product. The bad news is I'm going to give you the worst consumers in the world, children, because you're going to be asked to design a toy. Now let me tell you about kids. They are the most disloyal consumers in the world. You come up with a good product, it becomes an epidemic. Come up with some pile of toot and you won't be able to give it away. So the importance of this task is to make sure that you understand what your consumer needs and to bring out a product that is actually going to become an epidemic. As you know, you'll need to pick a new team leader. And as usual, Margaret and Nick are going to stick to you like glue. And they're going to report back to me what's happened. And as usual, somebody is going to get fired.
The candidates are off to a toy design company outside London. They'll get expert advice, but they've got to come up with original ideas. And they've only got 2 days to do it.
If we're really bright and within 6 hours we can come up with something entirely new that no one's ever thought of any before, well then you know what? That's good. Done us.
Mm. Yeah.
But we may have to work on the basis that we have to synthesize or translate an old idea into a new one.
Yeah. Yep. Mm.
The point is we're going back to playing to our strengths, and our strengths are what are we? We're men. Ditto, I think the toy we should be designing should be aimed at the boys.
No, I agree with that.
As for the girls, they've already chosen their team leader.
I think what I'm going to do, actually, is talk to the team about how I see my role as project manager. And
former radio presenter and Shell communications manager, Lindsay Bogard.
I think I've got a good chance of being the apprentice because I'm not scared to take some risks and go for it. I think I've got a lot of experience that gives me a sort of level head in business. And there's a fine line between taking risks and having a level head. But I personally really like to be direct. I wouldn't go out of my way to create an argument, but I would confront somebody if I think they need to be confronted in whatever way I feel is appropriate.
First of all, I was thinking it'd be good if we split into a business team, which goes round and gets research, looks at pricing, tries to figure out where the market's been going, and then we have a creative team that starts coming up with ideas. And it's basically going to be the people behaving like children all day.
Slime.
And that was
Slime was a killer.
That
was boys.
That age group.
Smashed it at
age.
It's
disgusting, it's filthy.
They hate at the age of rebellion.
Yeah. Like goo.
Yeah, the goo stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and that was quite good.
I used to play with that. That was hell. Check it on the wall, it was sticky and gungy.
It's the sort of thing that a kid can put in its pocket. Mm-hmm. And it's the sort of thing that a kid needs to have with him or her at all times.
To show
and
their
makes
friends.
Them cool. I mean, if we're saying boys are very competitive, so it's got to have a little challenge in there where mine's better than yours, or you can make yours better than mine.
So therefore we can think about colours.
Colours, exactly, I've got it.
Colours is there.
We've got to think about
10 a.m. The boys and girls arrive at toy company Vivid Imaginations. Tomorrow afternoon, they must present their ideas to the company boss.
Right, hi everybody. My name's Emma Shursky. I'm the marketing director at Vivid Imaginations. We'll be looking after you for the next 2 days, and we'll be taking your toy prototypes off you tomorrow at 4 o'clock, and you'll be presenting back to us and the panel of experts in this offices.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Good morning.
Morning.
Team Impact.
Here, the teams will have access to focus groups, toy makers.
Can I just show you to your room?
Oh. And thousands of toys.
Fantastic.
You should have
great
a number of brainstorm ideas and facilities, and I think you've got a list of contacts that you may or may not want to use throughout the next few days.
Can we just ask you some questions before you leave?
Yes.
Your designers, when designing a new toy, do they tend to stick with an adaptation of a classic toy, or do they completely kind of throw the boundaries open and really start trying to come up with something 100% original?
So it's a really good question, and the toy industry is a really good mix of both of those. Sometimes there are classic game and play patterns that are timeless and culturally will work across the world. So you can use those. Ideally, you're always looking for innovations.
The boys are still looking for a leader.
Yeah, I don't really think it matters.
Well,
a bit.
Has anyone got experience in this field out of those
three? Exactly. I don't. Nobody has.
Listen, let's not spend too much time on this, because
exactly, we've got
why it's important, it's not, you know, but
I'm more than happy to go with one of you two, quite frankly.
Well, I'm ready to go.
I'm happy to go with Raj. Raj.
Okay.
Raj.
You do that.
You the man.
Okay,
well
done.
We've got the focus group, haven't we? And we've already booked that for 12 o'clock.
Yeah.
Raj Donota, law graduate, bankrupt entrepreneur, and a bit of an optimist.
I truly believe I will become a millionaire, but you know, money is not important to me. Obviously, you need wealth, and you know, to be a millionaire, you have certain status in life. But for me, it's building businesses that are successful and innovative. That's where I want to make my mark, and that's where I will make my mark.
Excuse me, madam. Do you know where the Daisy and Clark store is for children?
Yes, I do.
Brilliant.
Half of the girls' team have been sent out shopping for toy ideas.
Right, shoes off. Absolutely. Let's get this done.
While Lindsay and her creative team brainstorm.
Where do we want to be at 12:45?
12:45, they're coming back.
We want to be.
We need
a shortlist. Of,
yeah, I was going to say we need to have
five or six fantastic ideas that we then ask the others to critique on us. How about a toy that, if someone else has got one, they're kind of modular. You can either put them together or they can interact together.
Badges, achieving things, modules, things you can give to people and put on their armbands, things you can club together and build up modules on. Maybe, you know, like either you can bounce, or you can do things with your arms, or you can do things with your legs.
Yeah.
What about something more like a kind of sling thing?
Relationship.
What about, well, let's think about this. They all want a text message. They haven't quite got a mobile phone yet. What do people used to do to text message? They used to have flags, and they used to be able to...
Semaphore.
Flags and semaphore, and you can just hold it up, and it means something.
Yeah. I think we need to come back to the idea of fun factor still and craze, and I think we haven't quite caught it with that yet.
I think we're nearly there on that.
Do you reckon? Okay, well, let's develop.
Everyone would be like, "What's that? What's that?"
Okay, so how can you make that into kind of the latest craze?
What did you used to call it when you sign semaphore?
Sure. Yeah, semaphore is the flags.
Well, could we call it something like semaphore?
Are we in agreement? 3:30 is in the deadline for concept.
Yes.
3:30 deadline for concept.
Both teams now only have 5 hours to come up with their killer concept.
we came up with a conclusion, rightly or wrongly, that 5 to 9 year olds, boys don't like girls, girls don't like boys, so we should go for one or other sex.
Absolutely. You're being too general. Hang on. You're hang taking on this as 5 to 9, that's what we were discussing. 5 to 9 is huge. Yes. A 5 year old will play with a hula hoop, whether it's a girl or a boy, a 9 year old won't. Yep.
Well, so we're saying boys, 8 to 9 girls. Boys.
I think so.
You're jumping the gun there.
Guys, I'm sorry, can I just interview?
Can we just finish off with this?
Too much debate, we need to make decisions because time's running out, yeah? We've got 5 minutes.
Time's also running out for the girls.
Down here, underneath the literally.
How much time have we got in this block?
Here we are.
Miranda.
Guys, Miranda, I think we need to shop the aisles.
Yeah.
Because at the moment, we've literally just done 2 aisles. I think, have a look round.
It's quite girly.
We've got 45 minutes basically to get to Woolworths next. Something trading so people can swap things with. We're looking at something magnetic, something very puzzly that appeals to both boys and girls, and the prices are under £10.
Interesting. Right, we've got something along those lines.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right, we'll see you later.
See ya.
Bye.
My views on Sebastian's idea, I think it's great. And I think
the boys have finally agreed on their concept, an updated electronic version of the popular card trading game Top Trumps.
At this level, all it is it's a card trading exercise. We're taking an old idea, mm-hmm. reinventing it, yep. and saying card trading has been popular yep. since PG Tips put, you know, little footballers' cards in the bottom of, like, tea things. I mean, you know, it's been going for years and years and years, and every kid loves it.
The girls' shopping group have just returned.
It's an interesting little concept. Harmless. I thought they were quite funny.
Hey. Hola!
Hello.
Now they're eager to hear the ideas the rest have come up with.
What this is a construction type of toy, and your basic component of it is shaped like a plug. It has 3 prongs, exactly like a plug, so that it could become part of a chain. And the fundamental idea of it is you plug it into the mains, that somehow, depending on the configuration that you do of the plugs in each other, it makes certain things happen, like a light bulb flash, or a fart noise come out, or a kind of bing.
This next idea is called semaphore. This is about people who are 5 to 9 not being able to text message but really wanting to. There's like 10 different hard plastic things on here with symbols on them, and they could look a bit like flags or just have a red dot on them. But on the back of them, you can write what that message means. So if you're imagining that you're in a playground and you want to send a message to a friend, you can, if you both know what that message means, you can just hold it up and people will be wondering what that is, but you both know what it means.
Okay. So what's that called?
Semaphore. Semaphore used to be the kind of signalling thing, so it's
aeroplanes. So what we thought of was like the whole robot wars concept. So you could get a robot building kit. This would go with the Meccano idea of the fun of constructing it together. And when you've put it together, you then put these 2 robots to battle and you bash them manually together, and parts fall off if you bash them hard.
Mm-hmm. Just to give you my initial gut feel on all of the ideas that were presented, for me, I really like the robot idea.
I'd really like it if you could pick 2 if possible, because we want to present 2.
Okay, so robot more. And I think the construction plug. But ooh,
for me, my favourite toy was the construction plug.
If I had to choose another one, I think I'd probably go with Sarah, would be the robots.
My favourite is plug idea or the robot idea.
Can I just say the robot as well, it's modern, it's the next century, that's quite apt.
For the next half hour, the scores on the doors, by the way, very easy. Basically, the plug-in got all of your votes, the robot got all of your votes, and the semaphore got 1 vote.
With 3 ideas chosen, the plug-in thing, the robot, and Lindsay's semaphore, the girls go to see one of Vivid's experts.
They had a number, I thought, of very clever concepts. They came up perhaps with too many, 9, I think, in all. Some of them, I thought, were extraordinary. The winner appeared to be a 3-pin plug, something that children are told time and time again to keep well away from. And here they were designing a toy to replicate the look of a 3-pin plug. I was staggered.
The mystical side is, would it be possible or dangerous, potentially, to actually have, you know, live electricity flowing through that so that...
Yes.
I mean, yeah.
Would that ever meet safety standards for a child's toy?
No.
Okay. Fine.
That's easy then.
With the plug rejected, Rachel's robot idea is now the clear favourite. So the teams can get inside the heads of their target consumers, a focus group has been arranged. A local troop of Cub Scouts and Brownies.
Right, in all of the big wide world, okay, what's the toy that you want most?
And why?
Yeah, what's the thing that you would love to have that you don't have?
Okay. What would you like to have?
A bouncy castle.
A bouncy castle? What's your favourite colour?
And for that...
Blue.
Blue?
We're going to start off...
What's your favourite colour?
Blue.
Blue?
Yeah.
You all go for blue? Blue. You want to take one of those? You can eat it now if you like. Whilst we ask you the next question. How about having one of those?
I'd like it if it was kind of a police robot.
A police robot? That's a blue. Very good idea.
Red.
Yeah, a police robot.
If it splashed me, it might accidentally blow up or something like that.
The girls' robot idea seems to be a hit with the kids, but Lindsay's still hooked on her semaphore.
I need to sell semaphore to the other girls because I really like that and it's going to be bloody cheap to make.
Yeah, exactly.
Hi, Lindsay, it's Miranda.
Hello, Miranda. Can you, or one of you, summarise what you've learnt at the focus group, please?
They love the robot idea. In fact, all the children love the robot idea.
Wow.
What they came up with from my group was to actually come up with characters for the robots, so it's like accessories and costumes.
But they just wanted to borrow the accessories from the friends and then lend out theirs, so they got different costumes for the robots.
Rachel gave me some feedback, and that was that I didn't communicate semaphore very well to you because she didn't understand it and she now does, and I'd like an opportunity to pitch to you all again.
What I find disheartening about this is that we've just spent half an hour with the kids talking about robots and things exploding and really getting a good feedback. And now none of that's relevant, really.
If we knew that they wanted us to run, the robot one was the most popular.
I mean, because as far as I'm concerned, semaphore was never even brought up, was it?
Project manager Lindsay has made a decision. Both ideas will be delivered to Designworks, the model makers.
Hello.
But with two toys, she doubles the workload and risks alienating half her team.
Miriam.
Miriam.
Rachel.
Lindsay.
So I think the design agency are actually going to waste their time on a product that I don't think is going to work at all, and they could be spending that time creating a really good visual for us so that we can present it easily to the board at the end of the day.
Do you think you might be able to get two products, whatever that is, by mid-morning to us tomorrow?
I think in semaphore, yeah.
Okay, I'll start with the semaphore, because I've got that on the top of the pad here. We thought it could be called Secret Signals. We're thinking that if it might be, it could be about the size of this pad.
The boys deliver their electronic game idea.
Yeah.
Hello, Impact.
Hello, Raj.
How are you doing?
Matt.
How are you doing? Welcome to Designworks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Right. Do you want to come through?
Yeah, please.
Good.
Okay.
Follow us.
So in terms of what are you expecting to get out of this session? I mean, it would have been good to have had like a bit of a phone call or something. Expectations then. You want to take the product back tomorrow. What are you looking to get from this session? What are you looking to take away with you?
It took longer than it should have. They are a bit behind, but what they've come up with has been a mixture of what quite a few of them thought of, and that's quite good because it shows they're working in teams. Paul at one point said, yeah, that idea is much better than mine, and I thought, well, that's quite good because he's the sort of person who likes his own ideas. Whether they should have talked to somebody at Vivid beforehand about generally what was in the market, what you could make for X pounds, etc., etc., I don't know. They didn't do that. They did it the other way around. It may turn out that was the right strategy. We'll find out.
Cheers, Matt. Thank you
for going anywhere.
With the ideas delivered, it's back to the house. It's been a long day, and it's not over yet. Lindsay calls a meeting to repitch her semaphore idea.
Can I just say that I just want to let you know I'm not totally hooked on semaphore. I just really want to make sure that we've got two options. Yeah.
You wanted to know how big the signs were?
Yeah.
Maybe this is tomorrow's discussion as well.
I think that the secret signalling is not very good at all. In my opinion, it's pretty awful because it's cryptic. I honestly don't think that it's a winning formula to sell mass volume. And let's face it, that's what it's all about.
In pure business terms, I think the day's going really well. I'm really pleased. And one of the reasons why I'm pleased is because I'm just, because you can be so focused on the task, I'm finding that a lot of the management styles or leadership styles that I'm using are just kind of coming together. I'm seeing my own behaviour in a much better light than I think I've probably behaved in the past.
If we would have known how enthusiastic you guys were about Semaphore, then perhaps we could have done our research a little bit more effectively.
Yeah, yeah. So to have Semaphore kind of put upon us when we returned to the second room, it didn't fit any of that criteria.
Oh, you don't look, time's getting on. We want to stop tonight. Well, no, we've crystallised the options. Okay. If it's essential now, because we're just crystallising the options.
Because you've crystallised the options, I'll mention my generic question. I just felt it was relevant right now.
Really. Okay.
And it's probably one of
elsewhere in the house.
Yeah. I think that is a shite name.
The boys' team struggled to name their product.
Okay. The initial thought that came to mind was switch bass. Doesn't sound great.
No, wait.
But it's a flavour we can work on, okay?
That sounds better. Switch bass. Matthew, what do you think? You're reading Sir Alan Sugar's bloody book
Matthew,
while we're doing
on,
this.
Come on, you're
going to lie. I've been here too many times.
Everyone's been here too many times, yeah. We're all part of the fucking team, so we all need to like concentrate and see what's going on.
Thank you.
Listen, seriously.
I will go along with
that.
Everyone
says. That
book.
No,
but we want your input,
man.
Well, then don't swear at me.
Everybody's. I'm not swearing you.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. You annoyed me because you need to be part of the team, okay?
I am part of the team.
You're not reading the book. You're not reading the book. All right, listen.
If you want me to add to the already raised voices and shouting, fine, but it gets absolutely nowhere in my book.
Okay. So everyone was having their own opinion, okay? I don't expect.
Not me. I'm kidding.
No, exactly, you were reading a book. I don't expect team members to do that, all right?
Oh, right.
Okay,
right.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, as before.
Yeah.
I'm always into the
lyrics, so you just pay attention. I don't see the reading book, I start twiddling my thumbs. Right.
I have been there. Okay, I understand.
It doesn't matter. Listen, how would you appear, yeah? If someone's standing there, you know, talking or, you know, discussing ideas, and I'll sit there and open up a book, like I don't give a shit.
With the pitch due tomorrow, model makers work through the night. The boys need a handset for their electronic trading game. The girls need a model robot. And for Lindsay's secret signals, a box of cards. The following morning, the boys leave the house, just 8 hours before they must pitch their toy ideas to the experts. The girls are running late.
What is it about them just not being able to get off?
No, well, they're just girls, aren't they?
Makeup they pile on, my God,
cool, they're quite heavy, aren't they?
But they need it, don't they?
They need it. An attractive woman does not need makeup, does she?
I agree totally. Yeah. I agree totally with
my
that.
My wife never wears makeup. And if I met her and she was caked on in makeup,
it wouldn't work.
She would have missed the opportunity with me.
She must be gutted.
Well, she's not, because she got it.
Lindsay has sent half her team straight to the model makers to collect their prototypes and get on with their presentations. Designworks have finished both the women's toys.
Have you got it, Jess?
It's the big reveal.
Done.
First, the team favourite, the robot.
Oh, limit to what we can do.
Fantastic!
So, flying your idea
that's
a bit more.
Yeah.
Then Lindsay's favourite, secret signals.
Oh, that is
secret
that's
signals.
Amazing.
But the girls still have to choose which one.
I would go on the strongest product right now. I would personally say it's the robot.
Well, I agree with that. So what do you think, Miriam?
I mean, I was trying to stay really neutral until I knew whether Lindsay wanted to call it, because I don't want to put all my heart into one of them and then Lindsay make a call and kind of have to shift.
Well, exactly, so we
Lindsay hasn't seen the models. She's stayed back at the toy company.
Just wanted to ask a couple of questions of Lindsay, really. She
close.
Yep, I'll pass you straight on to her.
Okay.
Sorry. Hi, Syra.
Hi, did you hear that, Lindsay?
Yeah, I did, yeah. Sounds good.
Brilliant.
What we wanted to ask you, we're actually going to start doing our presentations now. Now,
we want to concentrate our presentation on the one product. So do you want us to do? Do you want us to concentrate on giving an equal presentation on the two?
Yes, because we don't have enough data to make the product choice yet, and we want to keep our options open.
You want, so just to clarify, you want us to do a presentation for both products?
Yes, definitely.
Right. Okay, yeah.
And really go for it. I know that you've all got personal opinions, but please cast those aside.
I don't think really that we're actually, there's no real personal opinions here, if you don't mind me saying so. What's happened is...
We're a bit busy at the moment. Can you keep that data, keep gathering data, and I need you to work up two presentations because we need to make sure that we're keeping our options open.
You're going to want at least one of these.
For the men, it's much simpler.
And just blow the dust off there.
They've only got one prototype, and it's love at first sight.
So treat it carefully. What do you think?
I'm top job, really. You want one now, don't you?
It is. It's good, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
This is the next phase, isn't it? This in itself is going to lead kids to say, "I want that."
I want that. Yeah.
So the men even have time for expert help on how to pitch it.
So thinking now for your presentation this afternoon.
Yep.
You've got to communicate the product. It's not just a case of saying, here's a nice model, doesn't it look fantastic?
Yep.
It's all about communicating the concepts, and that's really where they're going to pick up on, and, you know, how is this going to work? So what we've done, these are visuals, just flat visuals, OK? Yep, we have actually produced a thing on a computer as well.
Keep it in the box, please.
Because the girls haven't decided which toy to go with, it's back to the focus group to put both to the vote.
Do you think you'd want to use this to send messages to your friends in the playground?
Yes. It's 5 out of 10 for secret signals, but 7 for the robot. It's Lindsay's call.
People have already got robots, so fundamentally, are we going to take a risk is the big question, and I quite like taking a risk.
Yeah. Ultimately, it'll be your call.
Not the pun.
No pressure.
Her call is to ignore both the focus group's vote and her team, and press on with both products.
I'm so excited about both products, I don't actually think it matters, and let's bear that in mind.
Exactly.
Good.
That's huge strength.
I like that line of reasoning. Yeah. It doesn't matter, they're both
We're
going
to win whichever. They're
exactly.
both so good.
Exactly. I agree.
Okay. Let's go. We're here.
But Lindsay's decision heaps pressure on the other girls, who have to prepare 2 pitches.
Why do we have to put the total market there?
Because it shows we've done research and that's what they need to look at.
Syra, you have to be clear about what you're asking. What do you want to gain from this?
Why don't you write it?
I'm not going to succumb to this really childish.
I'm trying to understand.
What do you need to know? Be professional. What do you need to know from this report?
I want to know what the total market is for the toys.
Okay.
Well, last year.
It's not what they've made. It's units. It's how many units have been sold.
Sold. Okay, but listen, I'm just trying to get...
Unit share.
Yeah, but is it...
Average price. There's no point in victimising me because you don't understand the report.
Right, brilliant. Don't get personal emotive language. Listen to the language you're using.
But you need to calm down. Too hyperactive.
Yeah,
like that. I can't work like that.
How it should be. We're coming over.
With less than 1 hour to go before the deadline, Lindsay decides it's time to choose a toy by vote. Again.
Right, we're going to assume that both products are viable, because if they're not, obviously we'd have to change our minds, but we need to move on. I'm going to ask you all to put marks out of 100. So you've got 100 points to allocate to these two products. Is it 80-20? Is it 50-50? And I want you to write them on a bit of paper and give them to me now. Thank you. All right, hang on. Okay, scores on the doors are... Secret Signals, 260 out of 600. Robot, 340. We as a team are split. I as project manager want to take a risk. I'm going to take a risk on Secret Signals because I think people have got robots and I think that's what Sir Alan Sugar wants is the next best thing. Now, who wants to present Secret Signals? Most products that are pitched at crazes will fail. Secret Signals might not work in the market, but it's got a better chance of being a craze than the robot product.
I feel a little bit disappointed about the decision deep down, really, because I thought the robot was an absolutely brilliant idea. I think the feedback we were getting and the body language we were getting from people who were producing it was very positive.
I'm confident that the product we've got's great, but I have no idea what the other team have got to offer. But I think we've got a good one. I'll be surprised if they beat it.
But I'm going to give this presentation 100% because I want my team to win. It's fundamental that we do, and I think my enthusiasm and professionalism will come across when I present it. So I'm going to take my personal feelings out of it because it's not about being personal, it's about the team winning.
$6.99. Sorry to interrupt everybody. Yep. Deadlines, 4 o'clock. Five. Got to collect all the prototypes, presentation materials.
I'm sorry, guys, it's 4 o'clock. You've got to stop now.
Okay.
Anything that isn't handed to me in
the
next 15
seconds.
15
seconds, okay.
Okay.
Take 10,
it, take it.
9, 8, 7,
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Finished.
There we go.
Thank you.
Well done, Ken.
Time for the pitch.
See you later.
Each team gets 15 minutes to sell its idea to the toy company bosses. They'll advise Sir Alan who should win.
Hello there.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Nick Austin. Nice to meet you. I'm Lindsay.
Hi, Lindsay.
Hi, Emma.
Hi, Lindsay.
Hi, Tracy.
Hi.
Hi, nice to see you. As you know, I'm with First Forte.
Hi, good afternoon.
Hello. Nick Austin.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi, James Max.
James,
Nick
Austin.
Closer.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
Let me hand you over to James.
So first of all, this is a trading game with a twist. Switchbase is an interactive device that communicates with other similar devices, allowing trading and gaming in what we believe is an exciting new format.
The three key objectives, actually there are five, the other two I'll talk about. The first objective was to develop a prototype and packaging for a new toy. The second, I understand that speed to market is absolutely fundamental to your toy market.
We've had very limited resources.
And that the key was things that I pulled out from that July 04, and it's in my
It sounds risky, but actually you're working off the basis of something that has worked time and time and time again.
What kind of profit margin would the retailers make on the cards?
On the cards, I think we're looking at 40%.
The idea of the cards is that the children, between them, in their little group who've got these cards, they devise their own meanings for these symbols. So there aren't particularly any pre-printed messages. And what the children do is they have a China Love pencil with their pack, and on the backs of these cards, they can actually, with their friends, devise their messages and write what they want them to mean. So for this one, you know, let's eat together, for example, at lunchtime. They all know within their little group that that's what that's going to mean.
Cheers.
Well done.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well done.
Cheers.
Time to call Sir Alan.
Hello?
Sir Alan?
Yeah, Nick. Yeah.
Hi there.
So, how'd it go? And you know, bottom line is, which one do you think was best of the two teams?
The boys' team. They turned out with a great product. If we were a company that specialised in that area, we may well have ended up going with it. It was that good.
Really?
Yeah.
That's excellent.
Now, the girls' team, the product, I wouldn't have bought it. I thought it was pretty weak. I mean, frankly, today's kids are more likely to be into SMS and mobile phones, electronic messaging, rather than showing cards to each other.
Right, yeah.
Maybe in the 1960s that I got away with it.
OK, well, thanks a lot for calling. And
I'll get the toys in the boardroom and then I'll come to the ultimate decision.
OK.
OK.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Task complete. Sir Alan and the candidates head for the boardroom showdown.
Hello.
13 candidates are about to become 12.
Hello.
don't win this, I will eat my hand.
Sir Alan's ready to see. You can go through now. Okay.
Okay.
Good afternoon. I told you quite a while back that I'm the one that makes the decisions, but I'm going to give you the opportunity to pitch your ideas to me. So I'll start off with the ladies first. Who wants to give me the idea? Who wants to tell me what was in your mind?
You want me to describe the product?
Well, tell me what you want.
It's the step before text messaging for children that aren't allowed or can't afford mobile phones or wouldn't necessarily be equipped enough to work with them anyway, where they can show each other pictures.
Sounds a bit boring to me.
I think a lot of mums will be very relieved to not have their children shouting all over the place because they just have to stop talking, basically.
You know, you try and stop children shouting and I think you won't have to worry about getting a job with me as the apprentice, you know. It's the devilment in children. My observations are that it's a bunch of cards. You know, that's my call on this at the moment.
James did the presentation, so just for the consistency, I'll let him finish off his good job.
Is that because you're passing the buck?
No, that's because he's worked on the presentation and, you know, as a good team leader, you know who's strong in your team.
Who's best at doing the job, is that right?
Well, basically, SwitchBase is all about having a small electronic device. It allows you to collect, so collecting cards. It allows you to swap cards and trade. And then it allows you also to have gaming interactively.
Where did the fundamental concept come from about this interactivity, electronic receive and transmit type of thing?
A number of us, I mean, I know that I came up with something where I said I'd like to have something in the playground where if it comes into contact with the other
where
receiver...
Where was you when you did that then?
That was in the first van on the way down.
Right, you weren't outside Argos by any chance because, you see, I found this morning, which is a similar product. It creates and controls your own tribe, and it's interactive and it's got infrared on it and all that type of stuff. You see a picture on the back where if you get in the close proximity of each other, you will interact with each other. And as I had a little bit of time, in a similar toy store, there's another device here which actually uses barcodes to read different things like this. So the point I'm making is that I'd like to know whether, honestly, you came up with this yourself.
I certainly didn't know of those products, anyone? Okay. I think the idea came from the fact that we looked back at which business or which types of toys were really successful. And I think in both cars, we came up with top trumps.
What I'm trying to establish here is that this was an innovation of your own. I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt. But your product is more of an enhancement of something that's already in the market. I've had a very long conversation with Nick Austin, and he's the toy man. Well, he don't know about toys, he's not worth knowing. And so my instinct was, I'm gonna have to go with what he says. Boys, you've won. Girls, you haven't won, because I find this boring. And I got to tell you, that's what they felt. They thought it was boring. As usual, I'm going to give the winning side a treat. This time, I'm going to send you off to a country home. We're going to do a bit of clay pigeon shooting. Hey. Ladies, you're going to come back. We're going to have a discussion, but eventually, one of you is going to get fired.
I'll have him this time, Peter. You see if I don't.
Say is that I'm really pleased that you were backing me and we stuck together as a team. So yeah, thanks for your support.
The girls return to the boardroom. Lindsay will eventually have to choose two of her colleagues to join her in the firing line.
You can go through now.
Okay, these boys have kicked your ass twice. It's disappointing. Now, I'm going to leave the floor open to you because you know what the outcome is going to be eventually here, okay? So, go for it. Who do you think let the side down?
I think that's a really, really difficult one to call because my personal feeling about this task, I think we were quite pleased with the product that we'd developed and thought that we worked really well as a team to put it together.
But Rachel, I want to hear what you think went wrong.
The ultimate decision to go with the secret signals toy, which was one of two choices that we had to make, which we left that decision until quite the last minute, was Lindsay's choice.
Okay, well, how did you vote?
I voted for the other prototype.
Let him join the party here, shall we, Robo? Adele, you wanted to go with this one.
Absolutely.
You thought this one sucked. So
yes.
What did you do? You're in a team, what did you do?
I asked for a private word. I had involved myself in the presentation stages and I explained to my project manager that unfortunately, because of the decision that was made, I couldn't take part in the presentation. At that point, I retracted.
So you abstained, really?
Absolutely.
I mean, Lindsay, did you detect after that there was a total disinterest in helping the group from her?
I didn't have much visibility on Adele's contribution.
Miriam, you've been very quiet.
Lindsay had asked me if I would be responsible for pitching the product. So I had my personal opinions, but I had to remain extremely open-minded to both of them, because if I was going to pitch something effectively, then I wasn't able to come down on one side of the fence before we'd made the product decision, which happened 20 minutes before the presentation.
Which one did you vote for?
I had to remain very split. I couldn't allow myself...
Does that mean 50-50?
It does.
Lindsay, I'm not hearing good vibes here. I mean, these people are being awfully polite in my eyes. They're pointing the finger at you, whether we like it or not. Because if my understanding is correct, came the 11th hour when the decision was to be made, and even when you had sight of the result, you decided that we're going to go with this. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
And what do you think now?
I don't think that our main sources of data to make the decision were our own opinions. And I think we were becoming confused about what really counted. And I was led to believe that I should trust the focus group.
Even though their final vote ultimately came down on the side of the robot.
I discount that, and I don't have the figures with me, but we decided on the way back, and we reached a decision.
No, we didn't decide, Lindsay.
No, wait.
We didn't, you decided.
You weren't with that team, so
you weren't with us.
Okay. Well, I don't think we can take this any further, really. Lindsay, will you choose who you want to bring back into this boardroom with you?
I'm clutching at straws here, but I'm going to be picking Adele and Miriam.
OK, so, you three, you can get back to the house. And you three, wait out there in the reception and I'll call you back in when I'm ready. Thank you. as I said several times, they're being awfully polite. When these three come back in, she's going to have to give me a very good reason, and the other one's got to give me a good reason also. I'm not too clear about what Miriam's position is. She can talk very well. It's one of those talks that is kind of like a drone that comes over. I don't even know what she's saying
it
a little bit.
Make sense.
And tell me, am I right?
Didn't make sense to say I'm going to remain equally committed to both. You can't be. You must have one you prefer.
You've heard more from Adele now than you've heard since
she's been here. I'm not clear what Adele really did, though.
Well, it's what she didn't do. I think she abstained, basically.
It's difficult. Adele obviously felt very passionate about that product. Whether she then didn't help in relation to the other. And I'm not clear about Miriam. Miriam did the presentation. It wasn't that convincing a presentation.
I think I've got a picture in my mind. I'm going to give them a last chance, and we'll call them back in and get this over and done with.
Yeah, Francis, send the three in, please.
Okay.
Lindsay, you said to me you're clutching at straws when you chose the two people to bring back here in the boardroom. Mm. I don't understand that point. What does that mean?
I just couldn't find a serious fault with my team members. I thought we did quite well.
What'd you do, toss a coin then?
No, I needed to think of a
rational... Well, there must be a reason then.
I perceived strengths coming from those around me. Adele wasn't actually around me, that's very unfair, but that's why I picked Adele.
And Miriam, what was the reason about Miriam?
She didn't do the research to contribute to the presentation. And so, because quite a lot of us are quite good at selling, I think that somebody else could have conveyed what she'd conveyed, maybe not as well.
Can I come in on that straight away, please?
Well, you'll have your time. Okay. So, John Blunt, who out of these three should be fired, do you think?
Who out of the three of us should be fired?
Yeah.
Adele.
And any reasons why?
Yeah, because I thought her contribution wasn't as strong as the rest of the team members.
Miriam, you want to talk?
I just wanted to say, in terms of my being dispensable, which is ultimately what Lindsay has said, I'm actually quite shocked by that, because at the end of the day, I was the only person who would have been able to effectively present either one of those products. Syra wanted to step out of the entire presentation at the end because she said, I don't believe in this, I can't do it. And I had to ask her still to be a contributing factor to that. Lindsay could not have presented even her idea because she couldn't even sell it effectively to the group, her team. Everyone said how apologetic she seemed about the idea, how they wanted to see her present it with some sort of passion. I mean, it was the idea that had come from her at the outset.
Your job at the end was to present what you thought up until 20 minutes or something like that before the end. You had to have a speech for both products. Is that what you're saying?
Exactly the task that Lindsay had set us.
So when did the decision come as to which one you're actually got to go and pitch?
20 minutes before our final.
So you're saying you prepared yourself for both?
Yeah, well, this is what she'd asked us to do, and that's what I had done. I'd prepared two
products. So again, John Blunt, who should go out of you three?
Lindsay, without any shadow of a doubt.
Adele.
You're probably aware from my comments earlier that all the way through, the secret signals had absolutely no mileage whatsoever in my mind. What was also a problem for me is the research and development. The R&D wasn't consistent, it wasn't used. When we tried to feed that back, it wasn't...
Adele, you're asking me to accept that you abstained from this thing, you had no heart in the product, but you stayed professional with it. Is that what you're saying?
I absolutely stayed professional throughout.
And you want me to accept that?
I would ask you to accept that.
And again, bluntly, who should go out, you three?
Without a shadow of a doubt, Lindsay, because she didn't listen to her team.
Lindsay, I'm not liking what I'm hearing here, and none of these people here are actually telling me anything other than this. They're pointing the finger at you. Tell me, convince me why you shouldn't be fired this week.
Me?
Yeah.
Because I went through the process of undertaking the task in the most logical and organised way I could. And we delivered something that I believed in, and that's the best I can do.
OK, I've listened long and hard here. Adele, you were faced in a situation with six people. You were not a team leader. You didn't like the product from the beginning, but you were stuck. And I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt this time. It may be that you might want to consider one day putting yourself forward to be a team leader.
Yes, I'll take that on board, Sir Alan, thank you.
Miriam, you're telling me that you're giving your heart and soul into your presentation. I wasn't too happy about the 50-50 thing, because that really was weak, as far as I'm concerned. Yes, I can understand that you're going to give your best because you've been instructed to give your best. But what I can't understand is you have not shared with me what your real personal like is on these things. And you've left me thinking, well, I still think both of them are quite nice. But anyway, what's said is said. Lindsay, in my opinion, you made the biggest error. You had the opportunity in your grasp. You heard from your colleagues that they all felt this thing actually had more legs than that, and you chose to ignore it, and you made a decision in the end, and that decision, I'm afraid to say, is going to cost you. Lindsay, you're fired.
Thanks.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they were sent out to make a toy. Not go and dance at two weddings and make two toys, make a toy. And she made that decision. And all the rest of them, you know, had to admit that. It was her decision, okay. It was down to her. And I've got no problem with her going, I'm afraid.
I think I kind of engineered the boardroom to get Adele sacked because I felt that she was the weakest link. So I put Miriam in because she's strong, thinking that that would then give Sir Alan Sugar no choice but to fire Adele. My values are about making a decision and sticking to it. If it's the wrong call, it's the wrong call. But, you know, if you're working for somebody, you can't sack someone when they make a wrong decision because you've invested so much money in them. You may as well keep them because they've learned something and they're a better employee after that. So, I mean, I don't share Sir Alan Sugar's values, but, he's got every right to make his own judgment.
One job, now 12 candidates. Sir Alan's search for his apprentice continues. Next week...
There's a pattern forming and it's not looking good for the girls.
I'm going to change things a little bit this week.
After two defeats, the girls are mixed with the boys for the first time.
Now I'm going to tell you what the task is all about. Buying.
You're not delegating the task correctly, can I just say? Go.
Both teams are going to get a list.
A cheap and cheerful new bowler hat.
Bowl of jellied eels. It's a matter of life and death.
You've got to 5:30 and you've got to bring all the stuff back to the boardroom.
Right, Miranda, you do not split up from us.
Thank you very much. We'll take it.
Respectfully, if you want to question what I asked you to do.
Now the teams have been changed. Who's next out the door?
I'm very, very disappointed. You have let me down. I've got to tell you. You're fired.